I weigh 3 pounds, you weigh six.
Oh, wow.
You need both hands to feel them.
Oh, I can feel it. Oh, the breasts are very tender. So it's 12 weeks old?
Yep.
And it's already...
It'll already address pretty close to 6 pounds.
Oh, man.
Ain't they a bastard? Whole breast, like...
So what makes it do that?
It's just a hybrid, some type, I don't know. There was a joke one time about chickens. The guy says, "Holy God, I love drumsticks. You got chickens with four legs. How are they? How do they eat?" I don't know. I haven't caught one yet with four legs. But them bastards are solid. Can you imagine a hunk of brat? Like, I shouldn't be killing them, but we're going to let them go up to 10 pounds.
Oh.
Your buns like skunks.
Oh, yeah. Well, this is a nice farm showcase you got going on here.
He used to have 700 sheep on his car accident. He said he'd never walk again.
So this really is a genuine barn find for the Volkswagens. So here are the barn finds. Oh, Volkswagens. Volkswagens everywhere. Oh, man. You could have... We're gonna have some fun moving all this crap out of the way.
Oh no, that's no problem. That's easy. Everything
just
runs.
Put on the front end loader. You gotta get everything all out of the way. Well, this is a 6.5 diesel, GM diesel. Crankshaft broken half, he said. So we'll hook this chain on here and get this lifted up. Out of the way. Okay, lift her up. Those tires come in really handy so you don't damage any oil pans. So I lifted up the hood and I saw a little... Oh, there's look at the mice coming out of this.
The white one?
Yeah, lit.
Right in there. Bastards are eating the cats.
They're evading the cats. I saw a little tail right. And when I opened up the hood, one went down in here too. Oh yeah, and there's a bunch of raccoon poop here on the ground, on the floor as well. And of course there's no key for the steering column, so I can't turn the tires, so... This one's been around the block a few times. Yours sits way up. Like sits way up high compared to mine.
Facades.
Oh, I see.
Shocks.
Oh, I see.
And they're springs.
I just keep on putting new springs in mine in the rear.
Facades for longer.
See, I fill mine up to the brim with catalytic converters and ECMs.
And then these tires are 13 inch high. Everything else is 14 low. So here's what I had when things were tough. And
this is the non-turbo you said, right?
I don't know if it has one or not.
Yeah, it's 1.6 non-turbo.
1,100 kilometers to a tank, and it would get 13 on hydrogen. And this was a bottle. It was all stainless steel, and we filled it full of distilled water, spoonful of baking soda, and that gas come off the top of that, went in through here and ran into your breather, and give me about another 30 more horse, and it go 1,300 kilometers.
Holy!
And it ran on that for one whole year, but the thing is...
No, that's moonshine.
Yeah, you know, but the thing is, hydrogen ate the stainless steel.
Oh.
It won't work anymore. And we can't get clean enough stainless steel.
Well, I can get lots of stainless steel.
But it's got to be real clean.
Yeah.
But it ate the wires right off. It ate them completely at the bottom.
Oh.
It dissolves it, eats it.
And
the hydrogen's so hot that and then you got your breather cap there, so it blows off just boils like a burger, and that come right through them lines, right into the breather. Bypassed everything right into the head.
Huh. You got a little bit of a leaky injection pump.
Yeah, but it's never been off.
Oh, really?
Nope, never touched it.
You said 1.1 million?
This got over a million on it. We took off 500, I don't know what's on it now. I should look to see how many miles went yesterday.
Took off 500, so when you smash it up in the insurance company, we'll still give you something for it.
She's got 525 on it, so it's got 1,025,000 500. So where's my gas gauge? It takes a while for it to warm up the gas gauge, but I went yesterday 422 kilometers, and last night when I parked her here, she was just touching the 3/4, so I still got another 600 at least kilometers to go before I run out.
Oh, and you got dual CD player. Oh, that's awesome.
Is there? That's a heater.
I know.
I never even use the radio. I never use all that stuff.
Hey, if you need a windshield, I got a good windshield.
I got a brand new car like this, too.
Really?
Yep, 92.
This moose head here, this looks pretty fresh. Farm fresh.
He was at 9:15 opening morning. We blasted him in October.
Oh, wow.
And then on Sunday morning, we blasted a cow.
There you go.
There's a beauty, that one.
See, my wife hit one with her, she had a Honda CR-V for 3 days, and she smoked a big buck, 9-point.
That's why I never even changed windshields, because as soon as it happens, this here is a lot better one, this one. Look at the white.
I think I seen this on a rabbit once.
On a jackrabbit. The biggest buck here was 310, dressed. That's with his guts out hanging, 310.
Oh, wow. That's big.
Most of you are only 210, I have a good big one.
That's big.
Oh, you want, here's, show this in the camera. See the hole up there 10 feet high? Over
yeah.
There a bit more. That's
yeah.
Duck in there setting.
What is that?
A duck in there setting.
A duck in the hay.
That's where she's setting. She's been there for a week or two. And there's another one in the next hole too over there. Next hole we're taking. Here, get this on tape. This is the noise the ducks make.
Oh, that sounds like a triple X thing.
Yeah.
Well, we got them loaded up. Farm fresh Volkswagen diesels. Right from the farm fresh factory. This one's completely rotted out underneath. And someone robbed the catalytic converter off of it. This one's actually a decent car, decent tires. I haven't really decided what I'm going to do with this one.